which means we're going to talk about the 45th president of the United States.
I thought that was Nick on there.
It began on January the 20th, but where will it end? In just his first 4 weeks in office, the president has declared war on the media and the intelligence services. A few days ago, he said that all of America's main news networks, NBC, ABC, CBS, and CNN, were fake news, and along with the failing New York Times, were the enemy of the people. The judiciary are in the firing line too. Even Piers Morgan, his biggest fan over here, is beginning to get a bit windy and telling him to dial it down a notch. But the problem is, Trump only agrees with those who agree with him. No less than 9 intelligence sources leaked about his former security advisor, Michael Flynn. The president is therefore already at war with the so-called deep state. How long, I worry, before the Republican Congress cracks and decides it comes down to a choice between Trump and the Constitution? I don't want to sound alarmist, but what more does he have to do before we have the people versus the president, or even a second American Civil War? No.
Civil War, Rachel?
Yeah.
Really? I mean, I agree with you. I agree with you. I think that it's going somewhere dark. But I actually have to say, I think that there is a more optimistic interpretation. Because if you look at what's happened recently, I mean, we've got John McCain praising the press, right? Which under any other circumstances, you wouldn't usually get.
Yeah, and actually, we've got a grab of that. Yeah. Should we actually hear what
sure.
he said?
Sure.
If you want to preserve democracy as we know it, you have to have a free and many times adversarial press. And without it, I'm afraid that we would lose so much of our individual liberties over time. That's how dictators get started.
You know, to me, to hear McCain say, I hate the press, but we need you, that's progress. To hear Gorsuch, his judicial nomination, talk about the importance of the independent judiciary, to see the women's movement and the Black Lives Matter movement coming together on the streets, you know, I feel that it is galvanizing people in a way that actually we haven't seen under the last Obama administration. And actually, when I look at people in their 20s who kind of came of political age under Obama, thinking that basically the president is a kind of civilized, benevolent, cerebral, sure. good
what
person,
it's doing,
they got a bit complacent.
It's mobilizing people.
Yeah.
It's mobilizing people to the point where they need to feel that their voices are being heard. And it's fascinating, if you've seen recent footage of a lot of the town halls where people have been speaking, Republicans and Democrats have been speaking, and particularly in the Republican areas, you've seen the backlash of people that voted for Trump actually saying, well, hang on, he's not actually doing what yeah. we want him to do.
Can I just spare a thought for the millions of people who are very happy in America?
Yeah, this was
I'm,
my
just gonna, I'm just going to give them a bit of credibility here. I mean, is it not yeah. terribly patronising to forget that there are people who, A, voted for him, B, are excited by him, and C, got what they wanted.
This
and right now
used...
they're getting what they want.
But, I don't have a problem with that.
Emma,
I don't have a problem
with that.
This
is why I said civil war and I was laughed at, because if we see the establishment...
Well, you,
if
Rachel,
we see the establishment and the
you.
Unelected dark state, i.e. the CIA and all those agencies, trying to unseat a democratically elected president with a mandate from 62 million voters, we are going to see something like, if not obviously, men with muskets shooting, you know, down south. We're going to see something akin to that if there is a movement in the 25th Amendment, which is actually the way you can unseat a sitting president. If that all goes on, you wait, you watch, folks. Next what were you saying?
I think you might be a bit early with it, and I think we're living in the era of fake news at the moment. And this feels a little bit like I've joined a fake news station for this
oh,
segment.
Oh, come on, Emma.
I mean, as in, what is your evidence that there's going to be a civil war? That's what I'm trying
no,
to
no,
understand.
No, no, no. A civil war was a provocative thing I threw in at the end of the queue to get you all going, and then, wow, it worked.
No, but Emma, where I disagree with you, sorry, and I know Nick.
No, that's all right.
Nick's being characteristically silent.
He is. Maybe that's because he knows he's on the wrong side.
He's brewing.
Sure. Where I disagree with you, Emma, is that I get it that there are people who vote for Trump, and I respect democracy, and that's their vote. Mm. But I think the reason to have objective concern is that he is damaging core functions of democracy. You know, by vilifying the press, he is delegitimizing people who hold him to account. That's really worrying for anyone who believes in democracy, whatever their political affiliation is. You know, for anyone who attacks the independent judiciary, that is
the so-called
is worrying.
Judge.
And it doesn't. So on one level, even if you're happy with his policies, you should still be worried about what he's doing to democracy. And the more patriotic you are as an American, you'd think the more worried you'd be about anyone someone who attacks
Rachel said in her introduction, Donald Trump only speaks to people, those who agree with him and who are right. Let's bring in Nick, because that seems...
Rachel.
Yes.
What don't you get? The only thing that's made any sense of this meandering parcel of cobblers that I've been listening to for the last 5 minutes is Emma talking about respecting the views of 63 million people. The more that Donald Trump says that the press are the enemy, the more his core audience love it. Because guess what? To a degree, they weren't the enemy, but it was all part of the cozy deal. The president always cozied up to ABC and CBS and CNN and the New York Times. And guess what? This guy isn't going to do it.
Hold on, you've had a second. Have you forgotten Fox, which is the Trump channel? Go on.
He gives interviews to Fox News. After that rather shambolic press conference, which was actually held to be an announcement, in fact, he was very critical of the press, he was on Fox News. What was the first question he was asked? Why on earth did you do a press conference like that? It was a disaster. Fox News told him what he didn't want to hear, and he still talks to Fox News. So you're wrong there. This is the collapse of what you love. When you say there might be a civil war, that is what people like you fervently hope. But guess what? She's right. Give these people a chance. Give him a chance. You just want it all to collapse. You're praying it will all collapse. You hope
Nick,
it will collapse.
I'm enjoying
because
it thoroughly.
It's against the system you love. And I hope it thrives.
One thing, OK, of what you're saying, the people that voted for him, the core people that voted for him, believe in what he's doing. That core is getting smaller by the day.
Look at his popularity rating.
Oh, please, are you going by polls?
You're going by polls,
we'd still be in New York. Well, we're still currently. They'd have won the referendum if we go back. You don't believe polls.
People within his own party are trying to distance themselves from him because of his rhetoric, because of his hostile approach. Now, of course, you can always say, oh, he was voted for democratically. It doesn't mean people have to continue to follow him blindly if he continues in the manner that he's doing.
The point of debate is whether America is headed for a civil war.
No, I don't agree with that.
She's mad. I mean, she is actually bonkers than her brother. But I do believe.
Come on, Nick. When it descends to personal invective, I know I've won. It's like God wins law.
What I do believe is that if it carries on the way it's going, there will be violence. There will be hostility because that's the nature of how he operates.
We're talking about how long can Trump survive in office if he's at war with the entire establishment.
How long do you give
it? Well, I don't think I would put money on it not being 4 years. And at least after 4 years, we know it's over.
What do you think will happen? Do you think there'll be an impeachment attempt, or do you think that there'll be some
There is already a move to impeach Trump, but, you know, we'll see.
It's not easy to impeach a president, as we all know.
If he's running the White House as an extension of Trump, Inc., I think that people are going to get sick of it, frankly.
Well...